Darren Guns. I don't know what I'm doing there. I'm just making random noises. Hello, everybody, and welcome to a revisited quick rinse. I hadn't said that for a while. Bloody hell. And as you can see here, the Tower of Guns still erect. Just a little brief pause there for a penis joke. And we are in, if you can see down there, we are in version 1.00E, aka SH. Oh, no, that's the word shrink wrap. Full disclosure, straight up, I am somewhere in here. Where am I? Definitely in here. There I am. Desmond. That is me. You spell it slightly wrong, but it's fine because who really gives a shit? What I really care about is how good this game has become. You know, I enjoyed it back when it was 0.6 something or other. I don't know. There's been so many names, and ever since then I've been helping out playtesting. Here and there, Indie Game the Tester finally comes through, and yeah, as you can see, I've been playing this game, well, to completion twice, hence the little stars here. We have Egon's Pride, dagger, that's my favourite gun, but because I completed the game with that gun, I don't want to complete it again, because I've already got a star. I'm trying to complete the game with other weapons. So we have the peas and carrots pistol, which is the little we have this gun here. Portable pizza thrower. Now we have two guns here that I haven't unlocked yet. I've got kill 24 tanks, which there are flying tanks in this game yet, and get to stage 7 in endless mode. Now I haven't even touched endless mode yet, because you know I don't really feel the need to just yet. But as the name would imply, it is endless. We have other guns here, but let's try it with the mini LHC gun. Aim for their mini large Higgs boson. Okay, and because it's a area of effect damage, I'm going to choose the perk that is immune to self damage, because I found that with this gun I was hurting myself more than I was actually getting hit by the enemies. So you know, the perks do work in some capacity with your gun. So as you can see, this game is it looks how it was before. Let me just shut my curtains because daylight is a load of bull crap, and I'm using the gamepad just to let you know that as you can see, like by the look in, it is, you know, it's very gamepad-ish, you know. Yeah, and it has functional support, but it's not ideal. Like, I'll be honest with you, don't bother. Just go to the mouse. Look, whoa, mouse! But if you want to just sit back and relax, grind out some levels, have a look in the hiding. You know, if you just want to explore this world without any like pain, Just sit back with the gamepad, it's fine. But I'm going to swap over to the mouse and keyboard because I'm in serious business. So yeah, this game is a first-person shooter that is Twitch-based, has jump pads, has quadruple jumps. What's five jumps? Quintuple jumps, if you have the ability to upgrade your character that way. And much like most decent roguelikes, your character progresses. I say decent. That's in my head. Like, you know, I think this game's decent. I think this game's very good, actually. Yeah, your character progresses as you play. And, you know, the every room's random. The order it's in. Not every room's random. I mean, this level has been pre-built by Joe at Terrible Posture Games. But, you know, the order of the rooms is random. The order of these secret bits here, the hidey hole bits are random. You're not guaranteed to have the same run twice, which is very exciting. And quite kind of essential for a game designed to be played on your lunch break. Like, I've completed this game twice, and it takes you about 45 minutes. Sounds fair enough. Like, both times, 45 minutes. Oh dear. So as you can see, this gun sort of slows down enemies, and in the process, it hurts me, which is why that perk is so important to me at the moment. And I just love having a look. Just every room, don't be fooled. Don't be tricked. Don't lead into his... Look at this. He wants you to jump in that travel beam. He wants you to, but don't be tricked. Shoot, explore. Do not run straight through unless you want to get the Egon's Pride gun. Just have a look around first. Look, there's little indications. There's things on the floor that can help you. I mean, they might not always be true, but just have a look around. There are secrets. This game wants you to find secrets. It even lets you know how many secrets you have and haven't found. Cup of tea time. As ever, these are your shops. Money. Top left money. Not enough money. We need more money. Let's jump in it now. Whoop. Oh, bloody hell, that was fast. And yeah, this game thrives on being like old school, but with a, you know, a new school feel. That doesn't feel out of date. You know, like some of these companies have been trying to make old shooters, and they always just feel old. Like, I didn't really get on with Rise of the Triad. Shadow Warrior was better. I like Shadow Warrior, but this just sort of has it. It does it right, and I. Oh, laser beams! Oh, fucking hell! I don't know how this game does it. Like, I don't know how it gets away with it. Just go around through there. Deal with that later on. But it just manages to feel fresh and contemporary while harking back to the old days. And I think it's all to do with just keeping it as a one-man band, you know? Like, this was all made by one guy. And I think his vision was never compromised by anyone, you know? It was just like, you know, this is what I want to do. I like old shooters. Whoa! And I want to shoot the way I want to shoot. I like the Binding of Isaac, so I'm going to sort of have that as well in there. And it just sort of makes for a really fun, fresh game. And I really like it. But then I would say that, wouldn't I? So as you can see, it does have a bullet hell-esque moments where there's just too many turrets and you have to blast away through them. Luckily, we've got a splash damage on this gun that will take out things around other things. And as you can see, I'm picking up red things. I'm picking up blue things. And these bars on the left and right, it's health on the left and experience on the right, and you can lose your experience by getting hit. So there's like a risk reward there. It's like when something pops and it's like pinata explosion everywhere, you want to run towards it and pick it all up, but there's the risk of that's where the enemies are, because that's where you've just been shooting. Now, I've seen this room a few times now. I feel like I'm missing something. Because this room could appear after I've got four jumps and I would be able to jump up here. And I just think, you bastard, like, I want to go up there. Why can't I? You know what I mean? That's part of the fun of this game, and that's why you will come back to try again. Boss rooms at the end of each area. This is Mama Spinbot. But, you know, the first one's quite easy, I found. Finded it. And it's not always Mama Spinbot, it's, you know, it could be something else. Oh, piss off. And hopefully this run will take us to something really interesting. I'm only going to show you, like, a couple more floors. Maybe one more floor, because I don't really want to show you what this game has to offer in terms of content. Oh, full damage is much better compared to the last build we had, where, you know, you'd almost die from doing that. Seems a lot fairer. And the size of the blobs and the things that drop out of a boss, they disappear quick based on their size. So the small ones will disappear quite quickly. The larger ones will stick around, and the items and stuff like that will linger around for forever, I think. So yeah, that was boss one done. I've got a thing called a ramp there. I know it's quite technical. I don't know if you know what a ramp means, but if I press E to use it, like it says up there, I can use a ramp. Yay! Hug bots. Everyone loves a hug bot. Oh dear. Even when you jump on them. So at the end of each boss, not each boss, but the end of some bosses, you get like a health reward on that podium. I don't know why some drop and some don't. There's no logic to it, I don't think. There is probably some programming reasons behind it, but I can't really work out. And as you can see there, it's telling me I've only found 33% of the secrets. Like, you know, I've played this game loads of times. I don't know where the secrets are. Entering the found dry. And we're back. Into one tube, out of another tube, onto a podium thing that looks, it reminds me of a pog. Like, if you could pick that up and throw it against some pogs, you'd win, man. So the foundry is all based on lava and fire, as you can see. And here you kind of ideally want the perk called Fire Force, where you don't take any environmental damage, because you can walk through these lava pools and stuff like that. What the bloody hell's getting me? Your item in the top right there has a yellow bar. That recharges upon kills and picking up yellow orbs. See, if we had Life Force, right? Let me show you something. Let me show you a little something, yo. We had Life Force, and if you could see through the lava, we could get through there without taking any damage. Now, luckily, it's worth going through there because it's an extra bit of health. Sometimes it's not. Sometimes it's just a bit of nothing, and you're like, well, there's no point going through there at all. But the health gods have praised us with some, secrets, hello, with some health and an extra health block on the left-hand side. They've had that go right to the top once, and I don't know if the game's difficulty changes based on how many items you picked up during your run, but like, I had like a full bar that reached up to the word speed there, and the game was flipping well hard. Not the dog from EastEnders. I mean, just really tough. Look at the chaos! Like, how could you not want to be a part of this? Just gonna blow everything up. Just why not? Because I've got the perk that, you know, stops me from taking damage for myself, it gives you extra incentive to go and just to run in, just guns blazing. And that's kind of like the, you know, there are some strategies to this, but some of those turrets that, as you just saw then, they fire these sort of like buzzsaws, kind of like Unreal Tournament style. Rip, was it Jack? I don't know. Can't really remember. These things here, look, they aim for you straight away. They're pretty much on your case as soon as you enter a room. And they will get you from any angle, so it's best to just get in there. You slowly work out which ones are worth taking out first. Like these ones over here, they're pretty rubbish. They've got short range. They will do some damage if they, you know, if they catch you off guard. Yeah! Can't get. Where's my. Oh, don't disappear, Ramp! Oh, bad Ramp! Naughty Ramp! Looks nice, doesn't it? It looks nice enough to eat. It looks like a chocolate bar, but it's for like wicked gold stuff in the middle. Anyway, let's get back to the foundry. So as you can see, levels 1 to 3 are quite easy to get. 4, 5 and 6 are quite hard. Not hard, but like, you know, it takes an extra bit of skill to get up to the 4, 5 and 6 levels. And you'll see your gun already, like my gun's already changed to these little bubbles. And it will drastically change. And you know, your bullets will become more rapid in its excreting of. So this is out on Steam now, Tuesday the 4th March. It is very good. If you like your procedurally generated first person shooters with robots in a cartoony aesthetic, you can't really go wrong. Give it a help! No! Oh, piss. That was my own greed then. Alright, someone's getting a bit excited, aren't they? I'm just so glad that this game actually got to version 1.0. Because, I don't know, if I was making a game like this on my own, there'd definitely come a point where I just think, you know what, I just can't be bothered anymore. Yeah, I'm just going to give up. Like, what's the point? I might as well just go and work as a stripper or something. I don't know if Joe's got the body for it, but we'll have to wait and see. I mean, he's not stripping. I didn't mean he's going to... Oh. I mean, it doesn't matter. Just leave it. Or you can ask him, actually. He's on Twitter, blank slate Joe. Joe, are you going to strip for Darren Gargette, please? He said he wants to see your body. Look at this! Look! Teasing me! But I thought I killed you. Piss off. How would you get over there? Is there an item that lets you fly? Maybe. Is it loosely named after a Super Mario enemy? Hello. Oh, I've only seen this room a few times. Oh. So yeah, this is Tower of Guns. You know, this is the main game. This is the main premise of the game. You run through arenas, very fast-paced, very frantic. It's a shame that I haven't shown you what it's like to jump 19 times in the air. Do you know what I mean? Because that is a thing that can happen. And it always seems to be like every time I go to do a video. Done a few videos and the runs just weren't that crazy. Like, they weren't the craziest runs I've had. Like, some of them have just been absolutely mental. I mean, this is pretty right. It seems to me I'm not the best at ramping, so I'm just gonna sacrifice my idiot self to death, because if I can't place a ramp down, then what's the point, eh? That's what we're talking about. a wicked Golden Eye-esque ending screen there. It could have done with the red dribbling down the screen going but I'm happy with that. That was Tower of Guns. That was 12 minutes 30 seconds. Moneys was 55. Final difficulty was 121. So the difficulty does fluctuate. And what's the reverse of fluctuate? Flatulence. Yeah, and you get all your stats. Everything is detailed here. Number of extra jumps, none. Speed 13. I've been speed 25 before, and it's been amazing. So yeah, it gives you all the information you need to know. You can even replay with the same loadout if you just want to go, oh, just another go, because you know you're gonna do that. Doing clumsy magic, and just like magic, clumsy magic, we are back. See you later. Tower of Guns. It's out now. Or like soon. Or maybe a year ago.